हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर सारिका मकोल, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, एमबीए डिपार्टमेंट, सागर ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशंस। टुडे विल डिस्कस अबाउट रिलेशनशिप ऑफ ओबी विद अदर फील्ड्स एंड आई हैव टेकन दिस टॉपिक फ्रॉम सब्जेक्ट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बिहेवियर इन सेमेस्टर 2 ऑफ एमबीए। नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, बिफोर गोइंग फर्दर टू अंडरस्टैंड द रिलेशनशिप्स ऑफ ओबी विद अदर फील्ड्स एज वी कॉल इट एज interdisciplinary approach and a field of study. So before going that, we'll just understand what is organization behavior. It is a study and application of knowledge about human behavior as individuals and in groups, in organizations, strives to identify ways in which people can act more effectively. So in other words, we can say that organization behavior is related to the understanding, prediction and management of human behavior in the organization. Because in the organization, we normally work in three levels: as an individual, as a group and as an organization. Whenever we enter the organization, we come over there as an individual goals, with our individual goals. But over there, we work in a team and for the group goals. And that group is further working to achieve the organizational goals. So basically, it is a chain in which we work for the to understand the behavior of humans. This slide shows you that organization behavior constitutes two words: organization and behavior. Where organization means integration of various individuals, groups and structure, and behavior inculcates what they do and how they do it. And that both combinedly means study of human behavior in the organization. As we all know that organization cannot run with the help of human beings. So we have to be very humanistic and optimistic to achieve the organizational goals efficiently and effectively. To be successful in any kind of organizational goal, one has to understand the behavior of its employees as well as employers. So now, various disciplines or relationship of OB with other fields is, OB is not a discipline in itself, but it uses knowledge developed in the relevant disciplines. So basically, it is a concept and principles from behavioral sciences like psychology, sociology, social psychology, anthropology, political science, management, economics, etc. So in this very particular topic, we'll study that how OB is related with all these other behavioral science fields. Now see, this is the diagram. Just have a glance over this diagram. This contains all the other fields and their work and the impact of all these activities on individual, group and organizational level, which leads to study of organization behavior. So we'll do that one by one. First is psychological field. So we have to study that what is the contribution of psychological field towards OB. The science that seeks to measure, explain, and sometimes change the behavior of humans and other animals is known as psychology. It relates to our mind, it relates to our mental health. So that is why psychology basically helps in doing learning, motivation, personality. It develops emotions, it develops perceptual skills, training, leadership effectiveness, job satisfaction, individual decision making, performance appraisal, attitude, employee selection, work design, work stress. And if you see, all these activities are related to an individual, because learning skills can be improved not in the group but on individual basis. Only then it reflects in the group. Motivation can be done group level also and at individual level also, but once the individuals has to be motivated, only then the group can be motivated. Everybody has its own personality as an individual level. So that is why it is also related to individual. Then emotions, every individual has its own emotions and feelings. Every individual has its own perceptual level. So that is why all these parameters are related to individual level. The second field is sociology. As the name suggests, sociology means when you just be in the society, you be social. So study of people in relation to their fellow human beings is known as sociology. So we categorize this into two parts: group dynamics, work teams, communication, power conflict and intergroup behavior. So when we have work in a group and intergroup behavior reflects organization system. Then we work in an organization as a group. So we have to exchange technology. We have to adapt to the changes which are there in the organization. We have to adapt in the culture of the organization because every organization has its own culture. So this is sociology. So that is why it is related to organization behavior. It is necessary to study the behavior of human beings to inculcate sociology in the organization. Then is social psychology. It is the combination of sociology as well as psychology. So basically it leads to behavioral change, attitudinal change, whether it is positive or negative. There should be a proper interaction. Then you have to work in a group. Then you have to take the group decisions because it is related to social. So that is why it impacts the group level. Then is anthropology, that is the study of societies to learn about human beings and their activities. So basically it leads to comparative values, comparative attitudes, cross-cultural analysis, and that could be done only between the groups. Then we have to study the organizational culture as well as environment, working environment over there, because every organization has its own working environment. So that has to be studied under anthropology. So this is all about your various disciplines contributing to the organization field. So I hope the relationship of different fields are clear to everyone. So